Atomoxetine is one of the medications that is indicated for the treatment of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, commonly known as ADHD. ADHD is commonly observed in children, teenagers, and adults, and it may be associated with lack of attention, hyperactivity, increased restlessness, and difficulty concentrating. Such people are easily distracted due to lack of attention. Atomoxetine can be given to treat this condition, and it is classified as norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, and it works on the brain to improve the transmission of norepinephrine. This compound exists as a stereoisomer, and the R isomer of this compound is more potent than S isomer. Atomoxetine can be used both in the adults as well as in the children. However, it is not recommended for the children aged under 6 years. So today in this video, we are going to discuss the important facts about this medication, how this drug works, what are the important side effects, what is the dosage, important precautions and contraindications of this medication. All such points we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug works. Atomoxetine is a centrally acting medication and it improves the transmission of norepinephrine within the brain. This can be achieved by inhibition of its reuptake. That's why atomoxetine is called as norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. This is the presynaptic nerve terminal which stores norepinephrine. And when action potential reaches to this presynaptic nerve terminal, norepinephrine is released and it can act on the postsynaptic neurons to produce excitation. However, the released norepinephrine can be taken back into the nerve terminal by norepinephrine transporter, commonly known as NET. Now, atomoxetine can block this transporter, thereby it prevents the reuptake of norepinephrine into the presynaptic nerve terminal. This improves the levels of norepinephrine in the synaptic cleft, which increases its transmission in the brain. This may restore the symptoms of ADHD and it can reduce the hyperactivity in the people. To a small extent, atomoxetine can also block the reuptake of dopamine in the brain. Now, let us see the side effects of this medication. This medication can produce general side effects like nausea, vomiting, fatigue, and it can also produce abdominal pain and constipation. This medication can also produce somnolence, leading to sleepiness in the people, which also increase the drowsiness and dizziness. Dry mouth is another important side effect produced by this medication, and it can also produce headache and difficulty sleeping. Excessive sweating can also be observed with use of atomoxetine. In the men, atomoxetine can produce delayed ejaculation and prolonged erection. Now, let us see the contraindications of this medication. Use of atomoxetine is not recommended in people with severe cardiac structural problems, since this medication can further increase the symptoms of tachycardia, chest pain, and palpitations. In such people, use of this medication is contraindicated. Atomoxetine is metabolized by cytochrome P450 system. Among these enzymes, CYP2D6 is one of the important metabolic enzymes that is responsible for clearance of this medication. Few of the drugs like paroxetine, fluoxetine, and quinidine are the potent inhibitors of CYP2D6 enzyme, which may increase the levels of atomoxetine in the body when they are given along with this medication. So, potent CYP2D6 inhibitors are contraindicated with atomoxetine. Similarly, atomoxetine is contraindicated in people with narrow angle glaucoma. Since this medication can increase the intraocular pressure in the people with narrow angle glaucoma, aqueous humor is not drained properly, leading to an elevated intraocular pressure, resulting in blurred vision, eye pain, and even loss of vision. That's why in people with narrow angle glaucoma, atomoxetine is contraindicated. Since this medication can elevate the blood pressure in people with pheochromocytoma, use of this medication is contraindicated. Similarly, in the people who are developing allergic reactions towards this medication, again, this drug is contraindicated. What are the important precautions? Atomoxetine can affect the function of your heart. It can increase the heart rate, resulting in the palpitations and tachycardia. In people with myocardial infarction or cardiac structural abnormalities, this drug may increase the risk of stroke or even sudden death in such people. So if you observe any chest pain, particularly during the exercise, palpitations, all these may indicate some adverse effects of atomoxetine on your cardiac system. This is more important in the people with the previous history of any cardiac structural abnormalities. And this medication can also increase the blood pressure. That's why monitoring of blood pressure is required before as well as during the use of atomoxetine. This drug can also increase the risk of orthostatic hypotension, a sudden drop in the blood pressure while changing the posture. So in such people, a sudden falling can be observed. Atomoxetine can increase the risk of liver injury in the people who are taking this medication for above 120 days. Even though it is not common in all people, but atomoxetine can increase the liver enzymes and it can significantly elevate bilirubin levels. So in case of elevation of liver enzymes, this drug may be discontinued. Atomoxetine can reduce the growth in the children. Particularly, this can be observed in the children with age group of 7 to 10 years. Therefore, the growth of children should be closely monitored while using atomoxetine in them. This medication can produce one of the condition priapism. This may result in a prolonged erection in the men with delayed ejaculation. Even though this condition is very rare, but it may produce sexual dysfunction in the men, which may further complicate the symptoms of ADHD. So if any such dysfunction is observed, this drug may be discontinued. Now let us see the dosage of atomoxetine. Atomoxetine is available as tablets as well as capsules. For ease of administration, this drug is available in different strengths, 10 mg to 100 mg. This drug is always started at a low dose and the dose is slowly increased based on the efficacy of the treatment. The adult dose of atomoxetine for the treatment of ADHD starts from 40 mg given once daily. At least after 3 days of therapy, the dose may be increased to 80 mg given once daily, or it can be given as 2 divided doses. The dose increments can also be done after a few weeks of the treatment to a maximum dose of 100 mg given per day. The dose in the children as well as in the adolescents is based on their body weight. For the children and adolescents with body weight less than 70 kg, atomoxetine is given at a dose of 0.5 mg per kg of the body weight given once daily. However, if the body weight is above 70 kg, the adult dose can be used in such people. So these are the various important facts about this drug, atomoxetine. This is one of the non-stimulant medication that can be used in the treatment of ADHD, both in the adults as well as in the children. So that's all about this medication, atomoxetine. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel and post your comments in the comment box. Share this video with your friends and relatives. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.